welcome back to the Branding for Abundance podcast and YouTube channel. So my name is Dr. TK, clinical psychologist and number one branding coach for therapists. So today I am coming to you with an awesome episode topic, and it is called My Coaching Programs, the History of Them Behind the Scenes, hashtag behind the scenes BTS. So before I get into it, make sure that you subscribe, like, and comment in the comment box throughout. Let me know while you're watching, what is your biggest takeaway? What can you go and share with other mental health professionals? And also how you can implement some of these things that I am going to be referencing in terms of how I've built multiple coaching programs within my business, how you may be able to apply this in your business structure as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. So if this is your first time visiting my YouTube channel, then I do have a podcast setup. What I like to do is cater to various learning styles. Not everyone who listens to my podcast prefers audio. Some people are visual. Some people are like hands-on. They like want to watch the screen. They want to take notes at the same time and listen. And then of course, some people just like the audio, maybe while they're driving and things like that. So that explains the setup, but the way that I do any type of podcasting or any time I'm teaching, then it's very good for you to have a pen and paper so that if a aha moment or idea comes up or something that you may want to go back to flush out your thoughts and journal a little bit, then I would encourage you to press pause right now and go get your pen and paper. So as the title states, I will be talking about the history of my coaching programs. Okay. So first let me give you a agenda. So one of the things that I'm going to talk about in great detail is how did I start my very first coaching program and why did I start and who I work with. Then I'm also going to give you a little bit of background in terms of me working and how that was able to pan out with me having a job at the beginning of my business and then also being sought out from potential clients at the time, then became my actual coaching clients that were looking to do some of the things that I was doing in my business, whether it be private practice or other streams of income. And then also, if you want to know details about how I was able to successfully leave a six-figure job and create a six-figure framework for a mental health business on my own, then feel free to check out previous podcast episodes. I know one of them is called, how did I leave a 100K job and things like that, okay? So let me just give you some backdrop. So at the time of me starting my business, I had a six-figure job working for Los Angeles County Department of Mental Health. I am a licensed clinical psychologist, and I was actually working in the correctional facilities for about 4.5 years in total. So during my second year of working, I knew that I always wanted to have a private practice. So what I ended up doing is during my off days, because we had 3 off days while working in the jail system, is I dedicated, one of those days to giving back to my community by serving them by hosting having a part-time private practice. Over time, while having that part-time private practice, I then attracted other therapists, but the first batch of therapists were actually interns, and they just wanted to see what it was like to work under the belt of a psychologist in a private practice setting, okay? Because those are not things that are talked about really or at all in graduate school. So thereafter, I grew, I expanded, I had multiple interns, and then I started to attract more licensed therapists. And yes, I did all of this while working full time. And then what ended up happening logistically is I expanded my individual practice into a group practice, which meant that I incorporated. I had to get a lot of paperwork in order. I had to start payroll. I had to create my own onboarding process for new staff. So it was a learning curve. I made some mistakes. All of those mistakes have been laid out for you, and I continue to give them to you in previous and upcoming podcast episodes. And so then what ended up happening is I left my job, and my first month after leaving my job, I was able to build my private practice, meaning my individual caseload, fairly quickly because our group practice was receiving a lot of referrals just because of my reputation in the community. And I was able to make my first $10,000 month just straight up from my private practice. That did not even include other streams of income. That is major. And that is the main mark that a lot of therapists want to have. So how this leads up to my coaching program, as I then started to attract other individuals that were working for county government agencies or just a full-time job that structured itself like the county. And they were looking to see, how can I teach them how to do what I did? And so luckily for me, and I really say luckily, I kind of walked into being a business coach. I had no intention of doing so, but I had had at that time, what, like 12 to 13 years of being a college professor. So the reason why I'm bringing that up, and the reason why I say luckily, is that a lot of business coaches, they may have birthed their coaching business specifically because of what they learned themselves throughout their process, and people saw their growth and they were like, wow, like I want to learn how to do that. But on the same token, I believe that there's a difference between someone who can learn information and just apply it to your own business, and then there's a different breed of a person who knows how to take in information, apply it to their business, see wins, and then if someone inquires or if they want to build a business from it, then they actually know how to teach someone how to implement it. Those are two different people. And I see a lot of people in all different type of industries per se under the coaching umbrella that see that something has worked for them, and then they go out there and they offer something as a coaching package, but then they recognize that their clients are not growing. And sometimes as a business owner, we tend to externalize the blame onto our clients, but really we should first be looking at ourselves. What are we not doing to deliver the deliverables to our clients, if that makes sense. So nevertheless, I started to attract a lot of clinicians who were like, I wanna make 10K months. I wanna eventually leave the county. I don't wanna work for someone else my entire life. I wanna have flexibility with my time and things like that. So initially I started bringing people in, and it wasn't even, I'm gonna call it a coaching program. It was me more of helping people. And over time, I started to create a structure for the now coaching program. So what that looked like is, one person would hit me up on Facebook, because it wasn't really on Instagram at that time, or they would email me, or someone would hit me up and say, hey, can I give my friend your phone number? I told them about you. Or some of my current interns were like, hey, this person at my job was trying to figure out how I knew just all the stuff that I knew about private practice. I told them I was supervising you, but I told them kind of like everything I saw that you were doing, and they want you to teach them. And initially I was like, they want me to teach them? Whoa. But I said, you know, let's talk. I didn't know that that was called a consultation. So I began to get clients behind the scenes, and they would be on an as needed basis. Their program would be personalized. There was no online course portal like what I have now. There were no Zoom group coaching calls. It was just me and that person. Month to month, we would personalize their program. But then what happened over a 3-year course, you know, time frame, I started to recognize that I started to get a lot of the same questions, and I found myself teaching the same thing over and over again. And that's when the Dope Therapist Academy birthed itself. Okay, so I started the Dope Therapist Academy, which is my private practice signature program, and I'll give you the history on that. But that program started actually July of 2019, so it's fairly new. And what I typically do on a lot of my webinars when I lead up to maybe a launch for the academy is I let people know the history to show some authority in the field, in terms of not only am I good as a clinical psychologist with building a individual and group practice from ground zero into a $250,000, you know, revenue stream every year, but I also am a college professor. So that means that I have excellent teaching skills. Clearly, if I've been teaching at 3 different institutions for 16 years in total, I was also able to get testimonials and wins from my clients, but I didn't understand the value of even testimonials to put them on places like Instagram and YouTube. Over time, I started getting a lot of phone calls, and then people were like, you know, why don't you put it on social media like what you do? And so I started to talk more about things like Dope Therapist Academy, but if you need that one-on-one access, please contact me and then I will tell you the coaching program that I have, which I did tailor an actual package that was for a certain amount of time for a certain dollar amount, and they will get a certain amount of individual sessions. But that would be deemed as, I would call it, higher level coaching, because you're getting way more access to me one-on-one. And truth be told, we talk about way more than just private practice. So the Dope Therapist Academy, I am, as of right now, at the end of 2020, fourth quarter, I have launched the Dope Therapist Academy for a total of 4 cohorts. And I am just super enthused to be able to say that successfully. I've had a lot of clinicians throughout the United States, over 25 states, I've served clinicians so that they can see their foundations of their private practice grow. Okay, so I've already told you in summary so far that I've started my business coaching programs for more of a one-on-one framework. And then I started getting more and more questions. So then I started to recognize that the clinicians needed a community. And what I've recognized about the community is that they've developed their own mini partnerships and business relationships outside of work. And that's one of the things that I thrive on, because I feel like so many therapists, we meet so many great people in graduate school, and then we graduate and we go on about our way, or maybe we all flew in and stayed at a different location to attend grad school. And then we make, like I did, I returned back home to Southern California, just from Northern California, but still, it's not like I talk and see those people. So sometimes beyond your coworkers and colleagues, if you leave your job, you're pretty much by yourself. And I wanted to create a safe and fun and energetic space for mental health therapists to have fun while building their business, learn from others, and not fall into imposter syndrome or comparison syndrome, and they can really learn from one another. Okay, so Dope Therapist Academy was birthed in 2019. Just to give you a little bit of backdrop in terms of that program and how I've grew it over time in terms of even how it's been structured, is initially the program in July, it was on one course platform. They had recorded lessons, video and or audio or mix, in their portal. They were leaked, or you know, given the information you know, for the course, and then we met every week for 8 weeks for a coaching call. So I like to receive feedback. I had them do interviews after the program, and then from that feedback, just like the professor that I am, I implemented that feedback right away. And what I also noticed is during that 8 weeks, some people fell off around the fifth week, and I don't know if that pertained to maybe they felt like it was too much, maybe they did not, you know, account for, I'm going to say, real time management, and also maybe they did not hear me when I told them it's going to be a lot of information and you will consume it. It doesn't mean that you will apply it all right now. And even though I say that, I listen to my clients when they feel defeated, because I urge them to talk to me if they feel like they're not doing their work, or they feel like they have a comparison syndrome, you know, in comparison to the other coaching clients. I want to hear from them on the coaching call so that we can pour into them and in our online community. So one of the things that I heard during that time was that they were given enough time, but they also wished that they had just a little bit more time, and they didn't know what questions to ask on the Q&A call. So therefore they felt lost, so they didn't say anything, or they felt like their questions were too dumb, you know, to ask it, because they were, you know, surrounded around their counterparts, or they felt like some people were way ahead and they were really consuming the information and running with it. Therefore they just sat back and they fell off, and that hurt my soul, because I even reached out to my therapist. If I see that they have not logged into the portal for a minute or at all, I'll actually tag them in an email that I have pre-created, and I send them an email saying, hey, just checking on you, reply to this email, me and my team will get it. Do we need to follow up with you so that we can have a better understanding about how we can better assist you with being successful in our program? There's not so many programs that do that. I'm gonna let you know, every group coaching program that I've had, no one except for the one that I have more one-on-one, they didn't reach out to me and say, hey, you ain't logged into the portal, you not showing up to the calls, okay? So beyond that, we really have a big component of like rapport and relationship building. And I want my clients to be able to trust me and believe in me that I'm going to be there for them to help them build, brand, and market their mental health business, especially their private practice. So then I started to think maybe 8 weeks are too long. So then in May of this year of 2020, I did what's called an accelerated program. I took a lot of time off to implement, beef up, even have a new platform, which is beautiful, by the way. And I decided to drip out the information so that clinicians would not binge watch, because I also believe that from the last cohort, if people just, because I actually saw when they would binge watch, because I would get a notice saying that they got marked complete when they would binge watch, I think that that also kind of led to someone feeling defeated because then they had all this information and they didn't know what to do with it. And that's one of the things that I see a lot of programs make the biggest mistake is that they pack in the information in such a short time frame in a program and less is more, which is why we dripped it out. So the 4-week program was great, but then I got the same feedback saying, I wish we had more time. Then I started to think, who is my client? My clients are therapists. Therapists have been in school forever. A lot of us did not take a break. We actually went from K through 12, 4-year college, into our master's program, potentially straight into a doctoral program from there, you know, or some people just skipped the master's and went straight into their doctoral program. I'm sharing that with you because if you are a therapist and you've ever felt like this isn't long enough, it's probably because of the structure that your brain has as it relates to a learning environment, right? Think about it. You're used to moving internship sites every year, not every 60 days, okay? You're used to going to school every semester and getting a grade. So I decided to go back to the 8-week format. I still decided to do 6 weeks of coaching calls because I also embedded 2 off weeks, which meant that they were considered either self-care or catch-up weeks because maybe some students are behind in the academy, okay? So where we are now, because with the 4-week program, instead of me giving them uploaded content, I decided to teach it live. And when I tell you the testimonials as far as wins skyrocketed, I said, oh, therapists like to learn live. And so do I. So let's see if now I can use these live calls and I will upload them to the portal for these next 2 cohorts. So what it looks like right now, let me just give you a summary. If a student is in the academy right now, they actually see the live recording of the May 2020 cohort. But what they also see to me, which is a huge bonus, is they also see those therapists asking questions very similar to probably some of the questions that they want to ask, that they're scared to ask, or that maybe the therapist asked them and they were like, oh, you know, I didn't even think about that. So that way, when they show up to the live Q&A with me, it'll be all eyes on deck. Now, hopefully you've implemented what you've learned into your business and now ask me questions, I am all yours. So now what it looks like is that our Q&A calls are strictly for Q&A and to summarize what they've already seen in the recorded live call versus me just showing a PowerPoint that could be, I'm energetic, but it could be very dry to some therapists, okay? So overall, this is what I've learned from my experience. I know as a business coach, I can't please anyone, especially in terms of the structure of the way that my programs are developed. But I try my best to do a very good job with laying everything out in masterclasses, webinars that I do that leads up to a Dope Therapist Academy program launch. I'll also put everything on my website that's year round so that people can get on the wait list. For example, if you check out drtk.com/DTA, then you can look at least the framework of the program, which is BRAND. I will teach you how to create a 5-year blueprint for your private practice. I will teach you how to reach your ideal clients through certain frameworks that I teach you to develop on your own as well. I teach you how to automate your back office because this is building up or rebranding, if you have a private practice, the foundations of your business. I'll also teach you how to identify your niche so that that can lead to streams of income later for your business. And then I'll also teach you the basic foundational levels of how do you hire individuals to help you get your time back of being a business owner. So if you want to get on the wait list and check out the framework, I would highly encourage you to head over to my website /DTA or just click on the DTA box at the top of the menu and you can check out the framework and get yourself on the wait list. Okay. Also what I've learned is that people like to engage with me before joining my program to be able to ask questions to make sure that they're clear on what I offer. So if I ever offer a masterclass and I'm also talking about the beginning stages of the Dope Therapist Academy, it's going to come out soon. Odds are I'm going to introduce you to the Academy at the end of that call. So I would highly encourage you not only to show up for the masterclass, which is typically a webinar, but also stay to the end because that's when you'll be able to ask live life questions in the chat box. Okay. Also, I talk about the benefits of group coaching. Some people want to dive straight into one-on-one coaching, but you really have to have a certain level of accountability and really know where you want your business to go for one-on-one coaching, because in the next podcast episode, I'm going to break down the new version for 2021 of the Elite Coaching Program, which is my signature 101, one-on-one, higher level, mastermind VIP access coaching call. Okay. So let me ask you a question, because I've already given you the backdrop of like where I come from in terms of how I grew my coaching business, how the Dope Therapist Academy has changed over time for the good. And yes, there's going to be a future episode to break down, of course, what DTA 2021 is going to look like. And I'm super excited to be able to share some epic news, but I do have some questions for you, because the Elite Mastermind one-on-one coaching program will be launching like now by the time you see this video. Okay. So let me ask you a question. Do you want to either learn or expand or scale in any of the following areas? Do you want to learn how to host profitable live events, whether they be in person or virtually like retreats? Do you want to become a speaker or enhance your speaking engagements? Do you want to learn how to podcast or YouTube? Do you want to learn the ins and outs of email marketing so that you can nurture your audience and also deliver valuable content beyond just therapy services? Because not everybody will be a good match for you. Not everybody may be able to pay your fees, but it doesn't mean that you cannot create also digital products. Do you want to learn how to brand and market your private practice on another level, or even build a group practice, and a whole lot more? So what I've done is I've created a similar structure for the Elite Coaching Program, just like I have for DTA. Okay. And the next podcast episode and YouTube video will be solely dedicated to me breaking down all the deets to the Elite Coaching. And I'm super juiced about this. Okay. So let me just tell you this. It is a 6 month plus program, meaning it's actually like 10 months in total with a graduation. You do get one-on-one coaching. And the reason for me creating this was because from a lot of my one-on-one clients going into an actual structure for 6 months with me one-on-one, I recognized that they were missing one big thing: community. Community, because they wanted to talk to other therapists that were doing something similar that they were doing, but on their level, whether it be mindset, wealth mindset level, and scaling. Not just I want to grow a private practice, but scaling, meaning you're leveraging your time, you're hiring people so that you can do less and make the same amount of money. Okay. So after 2 years of fine-tuning my one-on-one coaching, I am happy to say that the Elite Coaching Program is now accepting applications, and we are expanding the program for 2021. So if you want to hear all about it, make sure that you tune in to the next podcast episode and video. As usual, make sure that you share this with some other mental health professional that you know needs this information, or maybe they just want an introduction to myself and my coaching programs. Make sure that if you're watching on YouTube that you like, share, subscribe, and comment. Also, let me know whether you're listening or watching this on video, what other things do you want to learn about in terms of branding or marketing a mental health business? I will be happy to craft out future episodes, because I'm already making my list for 2021. If you're not already, head over to Instagram, follow me at Dr. TK Psych, because I also post motivational information. I showcase testimonials of my clients, and make sure to check out all the resources that I have for you, like my private practice quiz, the Dope Therapist Academy link to the page, and also check out my website for Dope Therapist success stories as well. So you can check the link in the bio. I will see you in the next episode. Bye.